Hey, what's going on, guys? How we doing? Matt Antonelli here.
Hey, what's up, guys? How we doing? Today, I want to talk a little bit about tipping pitches. I got a YouTube message yesterday asking me as a hitter if I look at pitchers and try to pick up what they're tipping. But this video can work both ways. So it can work if you're a hitter, some things to look for to give yourself an advantage, but it also can be for pitchers to make sure that you're not tipping your pitches. So at the major league level, this is something that almost every hitter tries to pick up, and you'd be surprised at how good some of the players are. I've played with players in the past that can look out at a pitcher and it takes them a couple of minutes to try to figure out what they're gonna throw, and they're really, really good at it. It's amazing. So it's done heavily at the big league level, not done so much at lower levels, but I think it's just because players don't really know what they're supposed to be looking for and they're not really paying attention. And you'd be surprised at how big of an advantage you can get, but also how easy it is to pick up, especially with younger pitchers, because they don't really know what they're doing. They're not on television, so they can't see themselves. So they don't really know if they're tipping pitches, and it's something that's not really stressed at a lower level. So as hitters, here are some things to look at to try to pick up on pitchers. And then as a pitcher, make sure that you're not doing these things. Have somebody watch you, have somebody videotape you. Just be aware of it. So, a couple things. We'll go through a few different things that I look for and that other players look for. There's hundreds of different things you can look at. These are some of the main things, but you can branch off from these and start picking out different things. Obviously, I can't make a video an hour long on just tipping pitches. But let's talk about a few key things to look for. So the first thing, when a pitcher's throwing from the windup, this is probably one of the easiest things to look at, and it's focusing on the glove. So let's just say in a fastball grip, a pitcher's gonna set, typically, a pitcher will set with their glove more up and down, because as a fastball grip, it's easy to just put the ball in the glove like this. So look at the glove, look at the forearm angles. You're gonna be seeing this forearm more straight on. The glove is gonna be just about at the 12 o'clock position. Now, on a slider or a curveball, what a lot of pitchers will do from the full windup is because it's hard to get your slider grip or your curveball grip like this, this is a natural slider set, this is a natural curveball set, they're going to have their glove more this way. So instead of here, their glove's going to be slightly tilted this way for a slider or a curveball, something really easy to pick up on that most young pitchers have no idea that they do. So just watch the glove. Here's a fastball, here's a slider. Here's a fastball, here's a curveball. Really easy to pick up on. If you're a pitcher, make sure that you're not doing that. If you're a hitter, we'll make sure that you're watching this stuff. So that's the first thing. The second thing is something that I see a lot is from the stretch. So a pitcher will take their sign and they'll set at different heights for different pitches. So some, we've had pitchers that I've seen in the past that we've picked up on that'll set really low for a fastball, say. Or they'll set higher for a slider or a changeup or a curveball. Or the opposite, they'll set very low for a curveball because they're trying to get a good grip on it, and they'll just kind of keep going, and they'll set down here on a fastball grip. Say they have a fastball in their hand, they'll set higher because they've already got that grip and they're ready to go, and they'll set up here. So watch the heights of the sets. That'll sometimes give away what pitch they're throwing. Another thing is watch for guys spinning the ball in their hand. So let's say a pitcher has a fastball grip. They'll come set and they won't move the glove at all because they've already got their fastball, they're gonna throw their fastball, the glove doesn't move. Now let's say they have a fastball grip and they wanna throw a slider or a changeup or a curveball. What you'll see is they'll come set and you'll see the glove wiggling around as they're trying to get that grip, that proper grip, and you'll see the glove shake a little bit. So watch for that. If you're a pitcher, make sure that whatever grip you start with, let's say you start with a fastball grip and you're gonna throw a fastball, make sure that you just don't go set, don't move the glove and throw. Come set, re-grip the fastball so you're at least moving it around, re-grip the fastball, then throw. That way, when you're gonna throw something else, let's say you're gonna throw a curveball or a split finger or something, you're not gonna get here and just move on that pitch. The second thing, if you're a pitcher, make sure, a lot of guys, what you'll see, let's say a pitch like a splitter, which is a tough pitch, you got to really dig on a splitter, or let's say you move your hand a lot on a changeup. Well then, if you don't want to, I recommend spinning it every time. But if you're going to throw, if you throw a splitter and it's a real tough pitch to get, well then preset your splitter so that you don't have to dig like crazy in there to get your splitter, because that's a pitch that's given away a lot because pitchers really dig on a splitter. So preset a splitter so that when you set, still move your glove a little bit just to make sure you're not tipping. Like I said, you want to spin or move on every pitch just to make sure. But you can preset the pitch that gives you a hard time to get that grip so you don't have to spin it so much. So I have the splitter grip. I set. I've already got it. I just move my glove a little bit, just make sure I've got it, but just to make sure I'm not tipping. Then I go ahead and throw my splitter. So those are some of the main things to look for. Like I said, there's a bunch of other things, and every pitcher is unique. But a lot of times, focus in on the glove, the position of the glove, the height of the glove, the wiggling of the glove. That pitchers give a lot of stuff away with how their gloves move, set, all that kind of stuff. Now, another thing, make sure if you're a pitcher, now let's say that a coach is really good at picking up on pitchers tipping, or a player on the bench is really, really good. Well, they need to signal in to the hitter what pitch is coming. So make sure if you're on deep, if you're the defensive team, if you're a pitcher, make sure that you're aware. If you hear something out of the ordinary, if you hear pitcher, the third base coach or somebody yelling a number, let's say that they're going to go with numbers for fastballs, and you hear, hey, 2-1, come on, 2-1, and it sounds really, you know, if you just pay attention a little bit, you can hear, especially with younger kids, because they get out of control with it. Or say it's fastball is first name and curveball or off-speed's last name, and all of a sudden you just hear, come on, Matt, let's go, Matt, here we go, Matt, and it's something real, you're saying, that sounds awkward. Make sure you're picking up on that. They probably have your pitches, either from you or maybe the catcher's giving signs that can be seen by a coach. So make sure when you come in, you figure out what's going on. Why are they picking up our pitches? Just be aware of that stuff. But the biggest thing is to pay attention. When you're younger, you want to pay attention to everything. Don't be so zoned in on one little thing. But make sure in between pitches that you understand what's going on. Not just thinking the game, but your surroundings, that kind of thing. Are guys giving pitches away? Are they getting our pitches? What's going on here? So some things to keep in mind, always be thinking on the field. It'll help out both as a hitter trying to pick up pitches and as a pitcher or defense making sure that the other team isn't picking up your pitches. So hope this helps out a little bit. Leave any questions you have in the comment section below. Share the video, like it, send it to all your friends, all that good stuff, and we'll talk to you later.